Hello, I'm Dave Slopsma from Dimensional Consulting, and today I'm going to talk about least material condition and least material boundary. So what are they and when would we want to use them? Well, we use them when we want to protect a minimum distance, generally a minimum wall thickness. So we'll give an example here where we have a female dog who has not been surgically altered to prevent her from having puppies. And a male dog who then at certain times would like very much to get over to the female dog in order to get her to have puppies. So if we don't want those puppies, we need to make sure that at those particular times, we keep the male dog away from the female dog. And you might say we could do it with a single fence, but if you have, say, a chain link fence, the male dog could get kind of creative and still find a way to get the female dog pregnant. So we need to not just have one fence, we need to have two fences with a buffer zone in between to make absolutely sure the male dog stays away from the female dog when the female dog is in heat. We're going to do that with these two fences, and those are going to form a buffer zone, and the whole thing is going to be governed by this tolerance of position with the least material condition modifier and the least material boundary modifier. So we establish the inner fence as datum feature A, and it has a size, a max size and min size. And we establish the outer fence as our considered feature, and that is located relative to the inner fence with this tolerance of position of 0.3 at least material condition with the datum reference least material boundary. That is going to protect a minimum buffer zone that is going to keep these two fences apart. So let's see how it works. First of all, we're going to look at what happens when the two fences are at their least material condition, least material boundary. Because this 0.3 applies when the outer fence is at its least material condition size and your inner fence is at its least material boundary. And because these two fences we're going to consider to be exactly perfectly perpendicular to the ground, the least material boundary is going to end up being the same as the least material condition for the inner fence. That just simplifies things. So let's take a look at what this minimum distance is, this minimum buffer zone that we could have in this condition where both fences are at their least material condition sizes. So when we have the parts at their least material condition size, we have the inner fence being at its 19.7 size. That's the least material condition size for an internal feature size, the largest size. The least material condition size for the outer fence is going to be its smallest size because it's an external feature size, so that's the 22.3. And then the distance that the centers can be apart is governed by this. And it says when these two are at least material condition, least material boundary, then the centers can be off from being perfect by 0.3, but that's 0.3 diameter. And so radially, they could only be apart by 0.15. So then this minimum distance when the parts are at least material condition, least material boundary is the 22.3 outer fence minus the 19.7 inner fence divided by 2 to get it radial, minus our 0.15 that the two centers could be offset, or a 1.15 difference that will never be violated. This is the minimum distance that this buffer zone will be. So that's at least material condition, least material boundary. Let's see what happens when these two fences are at their max material condition, max material boundary size. Well, max material condition for the outer fence being an external feature size is going to be 22.7. Max material condition, and in this case, max material boundary for the inner fence is going to be at its smallest allowable size of 19.3. Now our callout says that we can have a bonus tolerance, and this says we can have datum feature shift. Our bonus tolerance we always calculate from the size tolerance of the considered feature. And so that's going to be the MMC size minus the LMC size, or 0.4. The datum feature shift, we're going to calculate from the size of the datum feature. In this case, it's going to be the LMC size minus the MMC size, 19.7, minus 19.3, which is again equal to 0.4. So then the total amount that the two centers could be offset from each other is equal to the original 0.3 plus the 0.4 bonus tolerance plus the 0.4 datum feature shift, but then divide that by 2 to get it all radial. And so then the offset that the centers could be is 0.55. So now if we look at the minimum distance here, that's going to be the largest outside hole, the largest outside fence minus the smallest inside fence divided by 2 to get it radial, minus the amount the centers can be offset from each other, and that ends up once again being 1.15. So we saw that at one extreme, when the fences are at the LMC and LMB sizes, our minimum distance is 1.15. At the other extreme, when the sizes are MMC and MMB, the minimum distance is 1.15. And if you take more cases, you'll find that no matter what the sizes are, as long as they're within their allowable size tolerance, you will never have a minimum distance that goes less than 1.15. So kind of the overall way to think of this is, when this one is the biggest and this one is the smallest, they can move this far. And then as this one gets smaller and this one gets bigger, well, this distance would get larger, but then they can be offset from each other more to account for that. But it'll always work out so that it will never end up with a distance less than 1.15. That's the way LMC and LMB work. And that's why we use LMC and LMB for minimum wall thickness. So that's my tip for today. Now you can use LMC and LMB appropriately. Please visit my website at dimensionalconsulting.com, and thank you for your time.